share and subscribe. You don't want to miss out more on this channel. I need to help other children to start reading. It all started when I just started to give some podcasts of books, started to do some book reviews, started to give some motivational talks through podcasts. And I did one in December for Christmas, I did one in November for Diwali. And I do these big events in which I share so much with the children. And I do so many activities. For the four books, I have started with Juno and Ira. That is my first book. It's basically about two children that have adventures in a jungle near their house. I published it on Juggernaut. It was pretty young. I think I published it around the age of 10.
Welcome back to the channel. So today we have Arnai, who's only 12 years old, but already he's launched about 3 books so far. And congrats on your new launch, Happy Holiday Medley. And he's also the founder of Storytelling Society India. He works for the mission Read Children Read, and he has many more achievements in his kitty. And he's also a YouTuber. He also trains children on speaking, and he does many more interesting stuff. So let's go talk to him, get to know more about him, and let's all ask him how does he manage time to do so much at this young age. So
thank you.
Let's all welcome Arnai together. Hi Arnai.
Hi, how are you?
Good, thank you for coming here. So please tell us about your journey of becoming a young entrepreneur, an author, and a speaker and trainer. So you are just 12 years old, and tell us about the journey.
It has been a long time. I started approximately, 2 years ago. It all started with me just, I need to help other children to start reading. It all started when I just started to give some podcasts of books, started to do some book reviews, started to give some motivational talks through podcasts, and that is all what I used to do, because during that time I found out that many children don't read, like many children don't like reading, and I couldn't understand why children wouldn't like it. And so I wanted to motivate reading among them. So I started to do podcasts, I started to give motivational talks, tell them about books. I shared my blog, and like the community slowly started to grow. Like in WhatsApp, we had a group, and in there I used to share my podcast with everybody that came, and it started to slowly grow. After that, it started to feel like there was not personalized touch. Of course, I talk to them, but it's not like I talk to them in real time, right? So I decided maybe I should do sessions, I should do live sessions. And then I started to do live sessions of me teaching them storytelling and how to read in motivating stories among them. And like that slowly all of that helped me to become a better speaker, do better at what I was already doing. I just wanted to give something to the children, for the children. And that's how I started to do all of these. That's how I became a public speaker, and that's how I started to become a motivational speaker. And that's really how everything started for me.
That's actually really, really good, because you started very small and you've grown up so far. And as you said, why does not children like reading nowadays? It is a question mark amongst us, and you proved that it's a very good habit. And we can still prove our skills and vocabulary. And so you are the founder of the organization Storytelling Society, right? So, yeah. And you work for the cause or mission, Read Children Read. So tell us about that.
For Storytelling Society of India, it's a mission. It's an organization that I am the founder of and that I lead. It's to encourage storytelling. And I actually, there are many things I do under it. I give storytelling sessions each month. There's an upcoming January session in which there's going to be, if the theme's going to be about Republic Day, and there's going to be like, you know, that's going to be the theme. I'm going to give them stories about it. We are going to do activities together. And I did one in December for Christmas. I did one in November for Diwali. And I do these big events in which I share so much with the children. And I do so many activities. For Read Children Read, it's actually under Reading Shala, e-Reading Shala. So e-Reading Shala is basically a mission that I have. And under it, I do two things. I do a book review and I also do sessions. In the sessions, I invite many children to come and we all read storybooks together. I help them to read storybooks. They're usually very young people. So I help them to read storybooks. And for book reviews, I give book reviews on books that I like, books that I think are suitable for children. And that's it's actually, you can see, a YouTube channel. I have a YouTube channel under e-Reading Shala in which I post book reviews.
I really appreciate you because you've taken such a good initiative to change the society and bring in such impression in a lot of children. And I appreciate you once again for that. So you have written 4 books so far, and congrats on your new launch. Happy holiday, Mehdi. So please tell us about what are these 4 books all about and what are those books?
So the 4 books, I have started with Juno and Ira. That was my first book. It's basically about 2 children that have adventures in a jungle near their house. I published it on Juggernaut. It was pretty young. It was, I think I published it around the age of 10. I also had another book called Raffle and Bailey. It's a story about two men who get stranded out at sea. That was another book that I wrote. I published it on Juggernaut too. My latest book was Happy Holiday Medley, which is just released. It was a big book. It had a lot of work behind it, editing behind it. And I'm really happy that it came out finally. The fourth book is something that I'm working on. It's Mrs. Clark. It's going to be a novel about a teacher that has her life turned upside down. I can't give you much details as it is still coming out.
No problem. Yeah, it's definitely 3 books so far from a small start. Now you're growing, and again, you have a long way to go. And we're very curious to read your 4th book too, which is a novel, as you mentioned. So where and all have you been recognized for your writing?
I've been recognized on many platforms for my writing. One is on Brainfeed High. I had a book launch on it, and I got to showcase my book and showcase my writing abilities. Also, in my group Storytelling Society of India. Also, in White Canvas. White Canvas is a platform on which I gave in which I got to acknowledge my writing. Yeah, and those are some of the platforms that have acknowledged my writing. And it's really enjoyable that to see some, like, it go coming on the big level, some things that I've written coming on the big level.
Yeah, definitely. And I was also there for your book launch.
Yeah.
And it was a super book. I just read a few pages and I was very, very impressed. So you are the founder of a non-profit society, which is called For Children of Low Income Families, where you provide free education for children. So tell us how this actually works.
So it's basically e-Reading Shala is my non-profit organization, in which I share stories with the children and help them read it. I do sessions under e-Reading Shala in which I actually invite many children. We all read storybooks together. I help them read storybooks. I give them explanations of the names. I do some activities with them. And then after I have read the book, I read the book along, help them read. And as you know, as I also do it on YouTube, I give book reviews to them and share exciting books with them, which I hope encourages them to read more books.
Definitely. So you are a blogger, podcaster and also a YouTuber. So what kind of information do you update online?
So the information that I update online is one, I do book reviews, another one, I give motivational talks, and on Facebook I've been giving a lot of motivational talks, book reviews, etc. I have a Facebook page in which I've given like different motivational talks, different models, and it has reached a lot of people. I have gotten around 5,000 to 25,000 views.
You also upload a lot of stuff online, which is nice. Yeah. And how do you find time for all of this? You still have your school and you have to, you know, you're very, very busy according to me, because I just sit like a simple person. I attend my online class, I have my lunch, I have my food, and interesting to talk with a lot of more children like you. Maybe I will shoot for half an hour something a day, and you know, I'm very free.
Right.
How does it work with you?
So it's kind of simple for me. I go to school, and then after school is done, I take a little bit of rest. I eat my lunch, because you know, online class never gives you a chance to eat lunch. I get a free time. I spend some of it writing, just an hour writing. That's it, not much. But also I spend some more time planning what to do, and planning how and where should I do it. And it doesn't take much time for me to do it, because you can't do everything in a one single day. You have to do it over day by day, one step at a time. And that's how I manage it. Each day after school, I take a few steps, I do some things, and then the next day I do more. The next day I do even more. And that's how I manage it between school and all the things I'm doing.
Be successful, first thing is time management, second thing is punctuality, and third thing is to finish your work in time. What is your dream? Is there any dream award which you would like to achieve? Or
my dream is to have a dream. I've been having it for a lot of time. I just always have looked to the stars and thought, when will I be the one to put my first step on Mars? You know how Neil Armstrong put his first step on the moon? I was like, that was so amazing for me. And then that gave me the hope that someday I'll be the first one to put my step on a planet, on Mars, on Pluto. And my dream is to become an astronaut and go into space and step on a planet.
Don't worry, it's going to be soon, and I ensure that, because you know, you are a kid who's interested in a lot of things and who's successful in a lot of fields. And all the best for that, and I
Thank
hope
you.
To meet you soon once you achieve what you wished for.
Thank you.
And, so you told that you're working on your new book. So when do we expect it to launch?
My new book, you can expect it to launch in 2021, this year. It's close to publishing, it's almost done. You'll see it soon, perhaps in by the middle of this year.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we're waiting for that. All the best.
Yeah.
It will also be successful, like your previous book, Happy Holiday Mandy. And I wish you the best for that. So, who is your favorite author, and what kind of books do you read? Like, what kind of genre do you like?
So, my favorite author is... I mean, I have a few favorite authors. I read Clive Cussler, I read Rick Riordan, I also read Enid Blyton, Jerome Stilton, Eoin Colfer. I like to read all of these authors. My favorite one... It's a little hard to see, a little hard to say, because I love all of these authors. All of their books, I just enjoy them really a lot. I'm currently reading the Artemis Fowl series by Eoin Colfer, and it's turning out to be pretty good. The genre that I like is, I mean, I like all the genres, fantasy, science fiction, historical fiction, tragic comedy and you know all of those genres, but one genre I don't like is horror.
I am scared of horror.
I know.
But yeah, I love fantasy because I'm a huge fan of J.K. Rowling.
I forgot. I like J.K. Rowling too. I've read the Harry Potter series 13 to 14 times over and over again.
It's going to be very difficult for me at least because I would say that's the only book which I've read from the first page to the last page only because of how love and interest I show to J.K. Rowling. I love all of her books. I mean, but though I didn't read all of them, I watched it as a movie. Yeah, I still love it. It's never going to be boring again and whenever again and again.
Be sure to like, share and subscribe. You don't want to miss out more on this channel.